Hey everyone, it's vmcampos. Let's check out my recent comic haul. So first up, I've got Star Wars number 32 from Marvel Comics. This is part of the Screaming Citadel storyline. So, really cool cover. Look at that epic battling going on there in the cover. This is by Aaron, LaRocca, and Delgado. Star Wars Rogue One, movie adaptation. This is number 4 by Hauser, Lizo, and Rosenberg. So Noto continues his covers. Here's a very cool Darth Vader in his chamber in Mustafar. It's number 4. Continuing the Star Wars pickups, this is Dr. Aphra, number 8 by Gillen, Brocardo, and Fabella. Dr. Aphra, of course, the star breakout character of the new Star Wars comics. You can be forgiven if you look at the cover and say, oh, this is the new Star Wars comic, because Aphra is off in the corner here. She's kind of playing second fiddle to her own cover. Very cool dynamic art. And concluding the Star Wars comic haul, this is Star Wars Adventures. This is a free comic, and this promotes the new Star Wars web series, All New Adventures from IDW Publishing, September 2017. So it's got this sort of Clone Wars cartoony style with the new characters, Rey and Finn. There's Darth Maul, Kylo Ren, Darth Vader, of course. So you can pick this up for free and get a little preview of the series coming up. Here's some comics that I'm reading on the regular. This is Amazing Spider-Man number 29. This is in the middle of the Secret Empire storyline. So, amazing Alex Ross art. And basically Hydra, Dr. Octopus. Very cool, the mechanical tentacles, how they lead your eye to a battered Spider-Man. Alex Ross is the king of these covers. Creative team Slot, Gage, Immonen, Van Grabadger, and Garcia. I'm reading Spider-Man 2099 regularly. This is number 24 by David Slinney and Rosenberg. Amazing covers by Matina. I would say Matina gives Ross a run for his money. He's been doing these covers for a while. They're pretty amazing. And what's this? The classic Spider-Man 2099 outfit with the new outfit. Radioactive Spider-Gwen number 21. The funny thing is that sometimes they put the descriptor of radioactive and sometimes they don't. I don't get it. So it's 21. This is by Latour, Rodriguez, and Renzi. They've been basically on board from the beginning. So I like his covers, I like his art. It's a little bit more cartoony than some of the other realistic art that Marvel Comics is doing. But I think there's a space for all styles. And I like how it's just so nearly monochromatic red. Doctor Strange, number 22. The creative team here is Hopeless Henrik Chan. Not the usual creative team. But it is going along with the Secret Empire's plot. At least it's still the usual cover artist. And I love this style. It's realistic, detailed, but cartoony. And I've got The Unbeatable Squirrel Girl, number 21, by North Henderson and Renzi. Boys Night Out. This is a really funny book if you're not reading it. Henderson's art style is different than the other Marvel titles, but it really fits with the fun of this series. So some old-timers might recognize this cover swipe. This is The Mighty Thor, number 20. This is a cover swipe of the first appearance of Beta Ray Bill on the old Thor series. Creative team is Aaron, Dotterman, Shetty, Wilson, and Gandini. RD and MW after WS. Classic dynamic cover. So you have classic characters. So here's Venom, number 151. which is actually number 7 of the current series. I don't know how I feel about this weird new numbering. But anyway, this is the latest Venom series. Here he's fighting probably Devil Dinosaur. The Land Before Crime starts here, so a good jumping on point after the big revelations of the last few issues. Kind of like that style, it's over the top. A lot of the classic Venom teeth. I'm really liking this series a lot. Richard Corbin's Shadows on the Grave from Dark Horse Comics. This is number 5. This is an anthology horror series. I've been mentioning this book on previous hauls. I keep getting it. I believe it's an 8-issue limited series. There's one long storyline happening on the last few pages, but then it's a lot of short horror stories. Really great art by Richard Corbin. Just beautiful, horrible art in these books. So with a lot of classic Tales from the Crypt twists. World War Tank Girl number 3 from Titan Comics. This is one of the many variant covers. This is cover B, covered by Chris Wall. Super detailed, super realistic Tank Girl. In this story, basically the Tank Girl crew goes back in time to World War II. Hilarity ensues. Punch a Nazi badge. Bunch of little badges. Oh, here's the Kilroy Was Here badge. Cut Lunch Commandos. Bomb Happy. Really fun. Realistic art. I like the usual style, too, of Martin and Parson. But this realistic one works really well. Spawn number 275 by McFarlane and Kudransky. Very cool cover. Got the regular one, not the sketch one, or black and white one, or whatever. But, yeah, new character and front and center on this cover. Speaking of Spawn, I didn't get a chance to get the Spawn thank you retailers incentive thing. But I got the director's cut, special 25th anniversary, gold foil cover. It feels just like the 90s again. So 25 years ago, reprint director's cut of Spawn number 1. Shiny. Last Image title I picked up, reading this one regularly, I Hate Fairyland number 13. I only managed to get the regular nice cover. I didn't get the rude cover. I looked in two comic shops, I couldn't find it. But I've been getting both the regular cover, I Hate Fairyland, and the rude cover, Fairyland. This is a Scotty Young comic, along with Rankin and Bellew. Really funny style, very violent. And by now, if you've seen my comic hauls, you know I get this on a regular basis. Oh, what's this? Betty and Veronica, number 3. This book is got a lot of behind-the-scenes shenanigans going on, and it's been completely late and probably getting canceled. This is on issue number 3. Issue number 2 was published sometime last year. Right now it's July 2017, and number 2 was published like in November 2016. So the problem is that Adam Hughes is too good. His style works great on covers, but to publish a whole, 32-page book on a regular basis, it's not quite working out. So finally, number 3 is published. This is the Team Betty cover. And then I also got the Team Veronica cover. Now, both of these covers are amazing, but really, honestly, the Veronica cover is terrible. There's so much empty, wasted space here. Why is her face so obscured behind the logo? It just doesn't make sense. This one is great. Okay, yeah, you've got the Betty. You've got the Betty visible. She's visible. Veronica covered. Oh, I get it. Betty covered. Veronica visible. And she's visible. But still, it doesn't work. Look at this empty space down here. And then it covers the funny little icon up here. So, giving her glasses, and over here gave her a beard. So anyway, Betty and Veronica number three, both the Betty and the Veronica covers. Another Archie book here. This is the Archie Horror imprint. Chilling Adventures of Sabrina number seven. This is another book that hasn't been published in a long time. Number six came out months and months ago. I don't even remember when, like maybe even in 2016 also. The problem is that one of the two halves of this creative team, Roberto Aguirre Sacasa, is a superstar in Hollywood, and he's writing and working on the Riverdale TV show, and he's working on this book, and he's working on Afterlife with Archie, and he's running Archie Comics. So there's no time to put out the comics. Anyway, here's Sabrina number seven, regular cover by Robert Hack. Very cool style, very moody, very gritty horror style. And we've also got the alternate cover. I forgot to look up who did this one, but here's a vaguely anime-inspired style. Oh, here we go. It's style by Morita, however you say his name. That seems to say a copyright of 2014. So has this art been held onto for 3 years before it was used for a cover? I wouldn't doubt it with the erratic publishing schedule of Chilling Adventures of Sabrina, but I still love this book. Then we've got Rick and Morty, Pocket Like You Stole It. So this is number one from Oni Press by Howard Ellerbe, Farina, and Crank. They usually work on the regular Rick and Morty series. I don't really know anything about it. I just saw that it was on the shelf, and I got it. This is, of course, super popular Rick and Morty. I also got the alternate cover. So which do you like better, cover A on the left or cover B on the right? On the right, it's got a Tetris motif with fireballs and a much cartoonier style to the characters. And cover A has a more on-model style with a bunch of Mortys from different dimensions. And lastly, going to the newsstand, I picked up Batman Rebirth number 25, extra sized anniversary issue. So 25 whole issues of the new Batman reboot. So anyway, this is the War of Jokes and Riddles, part one. So we've got the Joker and the Riddler. And it's the newsstand edition. So as you see here in the barcode, it's a newsstand edition. You want to pick these up if you ever run into them. Newsstand editions have a value for collectors. So a quick recap. I got Batman number 25, newsstand edition. Rick and Morty Pocket Like You Mean It, number one, cover A and B. Chilling Adventures of Sabrina, number seven, cover A and B. Betty and Veronica, number three, cover A and B. I Hate Fairyland, number 13, regular cover. Spawn Director's Cut, gold foil cover. Spawn number 275. World War Tank Girl, number three, cover B. Shadows on the Grave, number five. Venom number 151. Thor number 20. Squirrel Girl number 21. Doctor Strange 22. Spider-Gwen 21. Spider-Man 2099 24. Amazing Spider-Man number 29. Star Wars Adventures free preview. Dr. Aphra number 8, Star Wars Rogue One number 4, and Star Wars number 32. So that's my comic haul for the moment. See anything you like? What are you reading? What are you picking up? What are you speculating on? Leave a comment below. Don't forget to subscribe for more comic videos and other cool stuff. This is VM Campos. See you at the comic shop.